who want to get out of the chains of religion, of dogmas and doctrines. I am a best example. So the way to do this is to approach them, show myself, and hey, I'm poor, but I'm not, I never wait for a God or a supernatural thing to give me these things that I want. And as a free thinker, I'm not saying that I become rich, but hey, being rich is not just wealthy in monetary or financial thing. At least I am wealthy in my mind. Now, the best thing to offer a poor man is a real tangible solution. Free thought can offer that instead of promises. For example, in your example, we see that in religion today we are now facing this problem of having many children as a gift of God, right? So as a free thinker, we can now see that this issue is really not an issue of morality, but it is more of an issue of a church dogma. So we are preventing, the church is preventing the artificial issue of birth control, not because it will help the poor, but rather because it is their dogma. As free thinkers, we can tell these poor people to have a mind of their own, to choose between dogma and reality. If I cannot feed my children because I have 20 children, for example, the church will not help me feed them. So it's better that I am poor, but I have 2 children which I can feed, I can send them to school, I can look at their well-being, than having 12 or 20 children which the church itself promoting but will never even lift a finger to help you about it. That is the benefit of being a free thinker. You can see through their dogma, you can see through their disguise, you can see through the needs of the church or your need. Maybe that is a free thinker, a practical free thinker for me. It is not about being about revolutions or not. This is more of a challenge for a poor person or an ordinary Joe to think. That's it. Yes.
Hello.
I'd just like to comment on why free thinking on the grassroots level is a challenge and has a slim chance of succeeding. The thing is, like this, for example, this group, we all live in far areas. I mean, one lives in Marikina, one lives in Makati. I think if we are to start at the grassroots level, it should be on a community-based area. Now, the problem is outside of that community-based free thought, let's say, group, there are, perfect example would be that our education system, I would say, is plagued by religious dogma. Now, outside of that religious, of that community-based area, you are attacked, but not necessarily attacked, but a lot of things will be against that idea of free thought. I guess what I'm trying to say is, free thought succeeding from the grassroots level may succeed only if drastic changes are done. Say, if you organize secularism, most especially on the education system. That's pretty much it.
Okay, but this is not really a automatic. We will do this now, but this is a start. What I'm saying is, it is already there. I got people from the grassroots level who are now already free thinkers. It is not impossible. The impossibility may be because you're not doing it, everything becomes impossible. But if it is a start, then okay. We are all different people, right? Okay, that's right. But we have all our jobs in life. Now, some of us has a more private life and they don't care, or they don't just this is just a whim, but for others, there is more of a goal in this. So I say that maybe someone or someone in this group is now trying to do it. He may not become victorious for a little while, but for some time, he will come to that. He will do it. I believe that. It may be a fate, no? Not, I'm using the word fate because we are all free thinkers. This is not an atheist group, but this is a free thinkers group. So I will use the word fate. It may be a fate for this man that he can do it. If he may not do it, then somebody from that group will do it for him. It's really not, it will be an impossible task, but I will not say that it is not improbable. It can be done.
Call me naive maybe, but I really have faith. I really believe in the power of I really believe the power of science. I really believe the power of human curiosity. And I just remember that Carl Sagan's thinking was once deeply influenced by his reading from the public library. But we don't have public libraries in the Philippines as extensive as they have there in the States. But you see, I think that when we have these establishments like public libraries, museums, that will kindle many young minds into free thought. And I'm confident with that. Now, I think the solution of free thought to the problems of human life, I think my personal ethic is act without hope. And I think that should be my opinion. That should be the main armor, I mean the main weapon of free thought. It's not to bring people hope, but to give them personal ethic so that they will act, they don't need hope to act. They only need that personal ethic and think to themselves that this is what I'm doing. I think that this is right because in my personal ethic, this is the moral thing to do, and I will do it. So I think that's what free thought should give to the people.
Very welcome. So that's it. I will give again the floor to Mr. Red for the next speaker. Thank you very much.
Thank you, John. Big round of applause for Mr. John Paraiso. Now, like I said at the beginning, we are not going to conclude anything here. We've merely started a discussion that we can continue online on the forums, in a future meetup, or on the next forum next month. So, if you have things in your mind that you'd like to share with the group later on, just write it down and I'm sure you'll have a chance to do so. Okay, so our next speaker is Mr. Jerry Villas.